Welcome to SATHVIDYA Java Tutoriols. Now we are in lesson 7, which talks about control flow statements. What is control flow statements? Control flow statements are those used to break the flow of the sequence. That means, till now what we are doing, whenever we write a code, it is going to execute one after one. That means in a sequence order. But these control flow statements help us to break that flow. That means we can execute those statements if some condition meets. We have three types of control flow statements: decision making and looping and branching. Using these three forms, we can control the flow of the statements. First, we will discuss about decision making. We have three ways in decision making. One is if then else, and switch. We are going to discuss about switch in our next lesson. First, we'll see what is if then means. If then, it is used to execute a certain section of code only if a particular condition is true. How the syntax look like? If we are going to give a condition, and if condition is true and we are asking system to execute statement or statements that are defined between this subblock, open and close braces. So how the flowchart looks like? That means if it is true, if the condition meets, and if it is true, then it is going to execute the statements and it will stop the process. And if it is not true, then also it will directly go to stop, or it directly stops the subblock. Example, let's think we want to welcome people who are greater than 30. For that, what we are going to do? If A is greater than 30, then we are going to say system.out.println come on in. Now let's see the same thing with an example. The same thing on our language basics SRC. Right click, go to the new class and say decision making here, public static void main, and just say finish, and a class with decision making got created for us. Now I am going to declare a local variable called int is, that is 12, and I am going to check if A is greater than 30, I want to display come on in. So I am going to save this and I am going to run this. So what it is saying? It is saying nothing, because our A is 12. This is way you can control the flow. This is not executing the statement called system.out.println, and it is going to execute only the condition meets true. If I make it like 32 and save it and then run it, what happened? Now it is going to execute it. So this is a single statement. For single statement, you can give subblock, or you can also skip giving the subblock like open and close braces. And if you are using multiple statements, then you have to give open and close braces. So let's see another example with multiple statements. Let's think if A is greater than or equals to 60, you want to give a discount of 10%. For that, what I am going to take, I am going to declare A is like 70 here, and I am going to make price like 300. And here, what I am going to do, I am going to say that total price is price, and I am going to execute some set of statements if the condition is true. So what condition I am going to check? If A is greater than or equals to 60, then what I am going to do, I am going to perform some calculation in order to give the discount to that person. For that, discount equals to 10%, where price minus discount. Finally, I am going to display the output here. So save this and run it. So what happened? Since the age is 70, It is going to execute this set of statements and it is going to give discount like 10%. That means minus 30, it is going to give you total amount is 270. And if phase is less than 60, that means like 50, what happens? It is not going to give you any discount. It is going to say what total price is 300. That means here we are skipping these three statements. Now, we also have if then else. That means till now what we saw? We saw only if statement is true, we are executing a block of statements. And if it is false, then also we can execute a block of statements. That means it is used to execute a certain section of code only if a particular condition is true, and execute the other section if it is false. How the syntax looks like? If condition, statement or statements, else, statement or statements. So the flowchart looks like this. That means if condition is true, it is going to execute some set of block, and if condition is false, then also it is going to execute another set of block. Finally, it goes to the out of the decision making statement. Example, if you want to find which one is greater among these two, for that what you are going to do? I am going to check 45 is greater than or 30 or not. If it is true, then it is going to say 45 is greater than 30, else it is going to say 30 is greater than 45. Now let's see same example on Eclipse. Go to the Eclipse and then if then else. I'm going to comment this. Okay, I'm going to comment this to make us more clear, and then let's talk about if then else. So for that we are going to take an example like find greatest among two numbers. I am going to take two numbers like int a and int b, and initially I am going to display a and b. So what is the condition I have to check here? If a greater than b, then system.out.println a is greater than b, else system.out.println b is greater than a. So now I am going to save this and I'm going to run this. So what we got here, our a is 50 and b is 60. Since 60 is greater than 50, it is going to give b is greater than a. That means it is going to execute the else statement. And if you give like a here like 70 and save it and run it, it is going to say A is greater than B. So we can also have if then else if. We do also have if then else if. That means we can also give if after the else statement. That means if you want to find greatest among the three numbers, then what you can do here, I am going to take another variable called int C is 55, and I'm going to say like system.out.println. I'm going to display the three numbers again, and I'm going to check condition like if a greater than b and a greater than c, then I'm going to say a is greater than b and c, else also I have to check another condition in order to know whether b greater or c greater. So let's check if b is greater than a and c, and else what we are going to do, we are going to see c is greater than a and b. So save this and then run this. So what it is saying, a is greater than b and c since it is 70, and if I make it c like 95, and then I am going to save this and I am going to run this. So what it is saying, C is greater than A and B. This is, in this way also you can execute if then else and also if. And we also have another if called nested if. So how do we do that? Let's take an example, like you want to make the four groups with the girls age group 11 and 15 and go as team A, and girls age group 16 to 20 as team B, and boys with 11 to 15 as team C, and boys with 16 to 20 as team D. So for that I am going to take two variables like age and gender. I am going to say gender like boy here, age like 19, and I am going to check condition like if age greater than 10 and age less than or equals to 15, then also we have to check another condition like whether he is boy or girl. So for that, what we are going to do? Again we are going to write a if. So we call this as nested if. We are writing if under the if, which is called nested if. So we are going to say gender is equals to girl, then we are going to place them in team A, else we are going to place them in team B. Again we are going to check the same condition, and if it is a boy, we are going to place them in, if it is girl, we are going to place them in team B, else we are going to place them in team D. So for that, save it and then run it. So what is saying? You are in team D. Team D means we will check whether it is true or false. So we have boy with age 19. Yes, boy with age 19 is in team D. And if I make it like 11 and save this and run it, then it say team C. Yes, he is a boy and with age of 11 belongs to team C. And I am going to make it like a girl and see. Save it and run it. So you are in team A because girl with age group 11. So like this way you can control the flow of the statements and you can execute depending on condition by using the if or if then or nested if anyway. I hope you got a clear picture about if. In our next lesson, we are going to talk about switch. So don't miss it. Keep watching. If you like this video, please like and share to your friends who want to learn Java from basics. And please don't forget to subscribe. And for our notifications, please press the bell icon below. And for notes, please visit www.it.sathvidya.com. Thank you.